Hey, what's going on, guys? This is MBDC back with another video for you guys here today. And today we're talking about The Flash episode 15 entitled King Shark versus Gorilla Grodd. So this goes without saying there are spoilers in this video. So if you have not seen the episode, what are you doing clicking on this video in the first place? Come on now. Also, like, share, and subscribe if you want to see more DC reviews like the one you're about to see right now and more DC news to come soon. Do not forget to subscribe. I think I just said that, but I'm gonna say it again. Anyways, getting on right on into it. This episode was fun. It was a fun episode, right? Very fun. Flash does this. I think when they, was it season three when they went to, yeah, it was season three when they went to Gorilla Grodd's like Planet of the Apes type thing and all that stuff happened. So they do this, the Flash does this. You gotta have a little bit of fun episode, break away from the norm, break away from the main storyline. As far as story goes, nothing happened in this episode story driven to the main plot of this season, except for the end. The whole plot of this episode was testing out the metahuman cure, the finished metahuman cure. And who better to test it on than like the super duper meta, because there's levels of dark matter, I guess, in certain metas, and who has super duper dark matter? That's Shay Lambden, aka King Shark, obviously transformed into a whole shark person thingy. So we got Dr. Lambden, Mrs. Lambden, coming back. They recast the actress, if you guys didn't notice. I mean, I know some of you who have been watching The Flash since season one probably noticed, way different lady, not even close to the same. The other lady looked older. This one looks a little bit more younger. But, and they cast a human. We knew this going in, that they cast a human version of King Shark. So we got to see that as well. The first time we got to see a human version of King Shark himself, Mr. Shay Lambden. So that was cool. The whole episode was getting Shay to take the metahuman cure so he's not King Shark anymore. So Gorilla Grodd escapes from Argus. King Shark escapes. Well, he gets Gorilla Grodd's trying to like mess with his brain and like creates a surge, and King Shark freaks out. They end up catching him. He was about to eat Cisco, and in combat, Barry the Flash gave King Shark the metahuman cure in his neck without his consent. And Caitlin and Cisco were not too happy about that, because they want people to have a choice not to be used as a weapon. It's to, you know, it's a choice type thing. So they were not too happy about that. But it turned King Shark back human again, like I just said. First time we got to see King Shark as a human. But Grodd escapes, takes off his crown, because Mrs. Lambden created this crown device for his brain so that way she can talk to King Shark, and they've been developing a bond. But Gorilla Grodd's whole plan is to get that crown after Cisco amplified it and use it to control the whole city, right? Because he has telepathy powers. So instead of him just controlling a couple of individuals he's close to, he can use that to project it farther and control the whole city. And basically, we thought we're gonna get Shay Lambden, Human Shark, or King Shark in human form, and Mrs. Lambden riding off into the sunset, like how Sherlock was trying to get them to do, ride off into the sunset together. But Shay is like, nope, turn me back into King Shark because I can take down Grodd. So you get a big CGI epic fight of King Shark and Gorilla Grodd. Now, they spent a lot of money on this episode, and I heard some people on social media complaining that they could have used that CGI money to do better stuff, to do other stuff better in other episodes. And yes, while that as true as that may be, you gotta have these fun type of CGI kind of episodes. When it started raining though, and they were on the roof, the CGI got real bad. It got real PS3 like real quick. But I'm not hating on it. I know they got a certain budget. It looked good. King Shark looked good for the most part. Gorilla Grodd looked really good up close. The close-up shots, they made sure they spent extra money on the close-up shots. But you gotta have this. You gotta have this, because then otherwise it becomes a drama and not a superhero show. These type of episodes remind you that you are watching a superhero show, not just some regular CW drama. If that's the case, you can go watch Riverdale or Charmed or whatever the case may be. But these type of big CGI fights and episodes remind you that you are watching a streamlined superhero show. And I'm not mad at it. I'm not mad at this episode. We got no cicada. We got no real, like I said, story progression. We did get Joe back. Very glad to see Joe West back. I know a lot of people were happy that they heard he was coming back after his back injury. Glad he's back on the scene. And we got Iris being scared of Cicada, being scared to work in her office. So her and Joe go you know, do a little bit of rounds so she can build up some confidence against Cicada. But yeah, all in all, it was a good episode. It was fun. It was a fun episode. It, like I said, it moved the story forward. Not much to really talk about in this review. It was just a fun episode. I think the CGI looked great except for in the rain. Close-up shots look really good. We got little mentions of Cicada. But speaking of Cicada, the only plot thing we got, like I said in the beginning of this video, at the end of the episode, Barry goes, maybe we can ask Cicada if he'll take the metahuman cure. So kind of like the whole choice thing, like they're not going to use it in a battle. Barry's like, maybe we can ask Cicada if he wants to take the metahuman cure. So I assume in the next episode or two, they're going to be, I did not watch, so forgive me. I did not watch the promos like right after the episode that happened. I stopped it right there. I don't know how to watch the promos, but maybe they're going to ask Cicada to take the cure. And I don't know how that's going to go, but you know, hey, we'll find out. That was the only plot thing we got in this episode. But again, not bad. I'll take it. Because like I said, I'm sitting there and I'm watching it. I'm smiling. I'm laughing. And I'm just enjoying myself. I didn't even take notes on this episode because it was just a fun episode. And I would definitely like to hear what you guys have to say down in the comment section about the episode. Everybody's been hyping it. Everybody knows it's been Gorilla Grodd versus King Shark. King Shark redeemed. King Shark's a hero now. He's all good. He wants to save his girl. He wants to save the city. So King Shark's good. Shay Lamden is no longer, I guess, perceived as a villain anymore. And then they put Gorilla Grodd to sleep so he can't be trying to escape Argus again. But yep, cameo from Lila. Just throwing that in there for those of you who are going to be mad because I didn't mention it. Lila's been, she's been doing a lot these couple, this season, these couple shows. But all in all, good episode. We need these kind of episodes. Don't be mad at them. Don't hate on them. Don't say they can spend their money somewhere else, because if they keep getting negative feedback on episodes like this, they might stop doing episodes like this, and we need this for it to just feel like a superhero show again. So stop hating. Roll with it. I'm not hating. This is MBDC. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.